In previous videos, we taught you how to use templates, how to build a flow from scratch to power the Contoso Flooring Twitter account, and then how to build an approval process on top of that to democratize your team's Twitter inputs. In this next video, we'll show you how to run flows on a particular schedule using a trigger called Recurrence. Let's go ahead and build a flow for the Contoso marketing team. Let's create a flow that grabs customer emails from an Excel table on OneDrive that the sales guy Dave uses when meeting with new customers and building quotes for them. Let's build the flow so that daily, the email addresses that were added to the spreadsheet are then added to a MailChimp customer list so they can receive the Contoso Flooring marketing emails. Let's go ahead and jump into the tool. All right, go ahead and click My Flows, and then let's click Create from Blank. To get our recurrence trigger, you can actually see that I have this schedule service right here in my top services because I use it often. But if you didn't, let's go ahead and type schedule. It'll pop up in the list here, we click on it, and then we use the trigger recurrence. Now, let's say that we want this flow to recur one time per day. So we can see that we set those actions there. 1 hour, or one is our interval and day is our frequency. Let's go ahead and add another step to get our Excel rows that Dave, the salesperson, is adding in daily. So we'll go ahead and type Excel, choose the service, choose the action get rows. Now notice there is a difference. There's get row where you can get a single row, or get rows which get everything new. So we'll go ahead and choose that. Let's show it where our file lives. Mine is in my OneDrive for Business, in my work folder, under demos. And then I went ahead and set up this sheet just for this demo. So this is the Contoso quotes sheet. And I set up a table within it. So we'll choose table one. And now, essentially what we've done is that every day, we're going to get all the new rows from this document, from this table in this document. So now we need to choose what we want to do with that data. So we'll go ahead and add a new step again. We're going to look for MailChimp. I just usually type chimp. We can see it right here. And then we want the action add a member to list. So we go ahead and click on that. Now don't worry about the premium sign there. If you guys go ahead and sign up for a E3 free trial, you'll be able to go ahead and test all of these connectors out as well. So now the first thing we need to do is we need to choose where we want all these people to go, what list. And so I'm going to choose the Contoso Flooring monthly mailer. You can see that over here on MailChimp, I've actually already set up a list for that. And so that's the one we're going to use. Now the status, we're going to look for it's trying to pull up some dynamic stuff here. This is what I wanted, the dropdown. So we can see here that you have a couple different things, subscribed, unsubscribed, pending, and cleaned. We're going to go ahead and set everyone that we add to this list as subscribed, which means that usually you have their permission to add them to the list. Make sure you do, otherwise you might have some unhappy customers getting some emails that they didn't necessarily want. Now we need to show the MailChimp what information is going to get passed to it. Three fields, an email address, a first name of the customer, and a last name of the customer. So let's go ahead and click an email address, and we can see that all of our dynamic content comes up from our workbook here. So you can see that we have first name, last name, contact email, company name, address, square footage, floor type, couple other things. And so those are all set up by the sales team. But for the marketing team, we only need three things. We need an email. So under email address, we'll go ahead and choose the contact email field. Now, as you can see, Flow did something interesting here. When we chose the contact email field, it went ahead and put an output parameter for us, which is apply to each. And so Flow was smart and saw that we were going to set an action that needed an additional action on top of it. And so now what it'll do is as it grabs one of these, it will create a new action for each row it grabs. The next thing we need to set is the first name. And obviously we can see right here from our first name column. And same thing with last name. Okay. And so now we have essentially set that every day we will get new rows from this Excel table and we'll grab the first name, last name, and email address and use them to populate our MailChimp mail list. So that way, all those customers can get all their Contoso marketing emails, and Dave, the sales guy, doesn't have to pass information to marketing, and the marketing team doesn't have to bug Dave for all these email addresses. We've made it super simple. In just a matter of moments, we created a data copy that moved files from one space to another, which saves the company time and money. Thanks for watching this video. I'll see you in the next one.